recording. I completely forgot that I wasn't recording, so hello anyone on YouTube who may have been missing this. I was telling stories, and I completely forgot that I wasn't recording. I set up a schedule. 13 days, once again. Sunday, week 4. I'm almost guaranteeing that they probably won't use Gold Dust on that particular... What's the pay-per-view? It's October, so it's probably going to be like Hell in a Cell. So I highly doubt that they're going to use Gold Dust. They might. And then EC3 may or may not be a part of House of Hardcore. Who knows? I hate the fact that one of the big guys that I wanted to get, EC3, like, is the thing that's keeping me from being able to, like, do too many shows with him on a Sunday, because you never know when he's going to show up. But yeah, I told the story about how I went to Domino's and got pizza a couple weekends ago after work. So it was after midnight, and then the guy said I looked like Seth Rogen, which is Seth Rogen that tall? I think Seth Rogen's pretty tall. I think he's like 6'3", 6'4". Seth Rogen's a pretty big guy. And apparently I look like Vince Russo. I have a couple of pictures on my Twitter. I don't post pictures of myself too often, but yeah. Uh-oh, you opened up YouTube. You get blasted with Brie mode. Oh, great. That lets you know that you don't need to worry at all about... You don't need to worry at all about being there. Is it like a G1 deal? I'm guessing. Is there a G1 thing tonight? Bam Bam Rising? Oh, a different Bam Bam. I'm like, he rose from the grave? What the fuck? I got like a heart attack for a second. I'm like, what? Bam Bam Rising? Like, oh shit! How is this possible? Oh, who wants a pay raise now? Alright, Mayu, I figured this was gonna come. You know what? I'm gonna keep you happy, and it's only $560, so she's gonna be happy about that. Nothing today? Ah. I noticed that because of Monday Night Raw, Balor's the... okay. Dean Ambrose is the champion, Balor's the number one contender, and Sasha Banks is the women's champion. And I've been on ASP just long enough to know that there's probably a lot of people on suicide watch on 4chan's ASP board because they talk so much about how shit. Because it's always Dean's a terrible champion, Finn Balor's a tiny manlet, and Sasha Banks has a receding hairline. And now they're like running Monday Night Raw. So there's probably a few people on suicide watch after that. There we go. It looks like a cross between Trent Beretta and Chris Canyon. I should bring that in. Raul LaMotta. I'll be Trent Canyon. With a question mark at the end. Introducing Trent Canyon? Kushida wants money. Oh god, that's so much money. This is where all my money's gonna end up going. All this spare money that I've been having, this is where it's all gonna go. It's all gonna go into paying people extra now that I'm bigger. I just wanna make it to Monday. Can I please make it to Monday? Without having people ask for more raises. By the way, I don't make enough money. Do you think you could give me some more? Fuck. Every day that goes by, I thank my lucky stars no one's asking for another $200 to show up. I wonder how old that Kushida picture is. Because I don't ever remember him being blonde. That's why I had went and seeked out like a more recent picture for when I use him. Robert Anthony. The dude used to work a lot here in Des Moines when he was Egotistico Fantastico. And then I found out that he was like a CZW guy. I'm like, that's like, it's like, oh, that's Robert Anthony guy in CZW. And it's like, oh, that's Egotistico Fantastico. I'm like, fucking really? there we go. Ken Wrestle, no show up your show if he's not happy with you. Oh, well. Oh! Look at that. Matt Jackson, contract offer. Goldust is officially gone from WWE. He has now joined Hawkeye Pro Wrestling. Tozawa, oh my god. A fully ruptured pectoralis major tendon. Oh my god. Okay, so he ruptured a tit. Sounds like. He'll be back in 2 months and 3 weeks. Yay! Yep, I blame Dragon Gate. I use them once every 2 weeks, maybe once a month. It's all Dragon Gate's fault at this point. By the way, I love the fact that eventually, it seems like eventually, they... Eventually, there is going to be a match between Mad Blanky and Monster Express again in 2017. So, be prepared for that. There we go. Yeah, the same... Sounds like the same thing Cena had back in, like, 08-ish? Maybe able to use surgery to Tozawa. I don't need Tozawa for anything, so I don't feel like doing that again. I've already had a rough experience with surgeries on people, so we'll just go ahead and leave that alone. If it was pressing, I might, but it's 2 months and 3 weeks. I can do without Tozawa for right now. I don't have anything planned, I don't have anything planned for him at the December end of the year show, so we'll just leave that alone. Yeah. I've had some... I want to see what does the medical look like? What do we got? Medium risk? No, let's not even do a medium risk. I'm not even going to take a chance. I have such terrible luck right now with that. Let's just not. Let's not. Only high-risk surgeries will fail? That's what you fucking think. You think high-risk surgeries will... Only high-risk surgeries will fail. Guess what? Only fucking low-risk surgeries fail, too. Sorry. I got angry, but... No, low-risk surgery... Trust me when I tell you low-risk surgeries fail. Trust me when I tell you low-risk surgeries fail. The fact is, Kairi Hojo should be back in 7 months. Kairi Hojo should be back in 7 months. It's gonna be 9. Torn rotator cuff. Low-risk surgery. It went terribly. I don't know why, but it is. And, so, yeah. By the way, fucking Io Shirai is going to have a meniscus tear for the next year. She's gonna have a meniscus tear for the next year that she's working through. How? You don't have balls to do that surgery, are you scared? Yeah, I don't want to be the one who fucked it up again. Yeah. No, trust me. Low-risk surgeries can fail. I've seen it firsthand before on this very stream. Low-risk surgeries can and will fail. Not all the time, but they can. So let's move on. There was a big to-do when Kairi Hojo got injured that I'm just not keen on, knowing that she's gone for the next 9 months. She's gone for over a year. I was not happy about that. Carlos Cabrera and Hugo Savinovich are not a thing anymore. I think Hugo Savinovich died. So one of them died, I thought. I can't remember which. I think it was Savinovich. I think I just assumed Savinovich because of how large he was. Do you know where Technical Masterclass matches should be placed in the card? I think I put mine towards the middle-ish. I've only had like one, maybe two matches, and that were Technical Masterclass. And I think I put that... Oh yeah, it was the... it was the co-main. But there was a match in between, at least. There was at least one match in between. So I put it somewhere about two-thirds of the way through the show. That's where I put my Technical Masterclass match. And I mean, you know, it... I gotta say, my Technical Masterclass match, you know, it... well, let me see. Yeah, it worked out pretty well, you know. A 78, you know, best match I've ever put on. So... That's just my my dealing with it. By the way, a throwaway Pete Dunne Lance and OI match is now the number 6 match. And what the fuck? It's now the number 6 match of all time from this company. All right, unread emails and decisions. Oh, great. Matt Hardy has chosen to relocate and now resides in Central Europe. Why? I'm not paying for you. Like, it's in the contract. I don't have to pay for your travel, so you can just do it on your own. You raise pure to high, and I want to do flippy shit, not pure. Scorpio Sky sustained a finger sprain. Watch him be out for that. Like, you pussy. Alright. He had a hernia, too. I don't think I'm going to bring him in. Why did Matt Hardy relocate to fucking Central Europe? Why is that a thing? TNA dumped him, I guess. Or he left TNA at some point. DPW. The fuck is DPW? It's not DDT. Dutch Pro Wrestling? Oh, that's why. He's the owner. He bought out a Dutch wrestling promotion. Why would you buy out a Dutch wrestling promotion? Why did you sell Omega to some dude? Why did you sell Omega to the head of NWA? And then decide that you're going to own a promotion in the Netherlands. I don't understand, Matt. This is truly the thought process of a broken mind. This is what it truly means to be broken, Matt Hardy. He wants to learn the Eastern here, more Eastern European accents. Big O. Oh man, all right. Couple hundred extra bucks. Can I stop getting hit up for money? Fuck. I prefer not to be hit up for more money, please. Can I just stop having to spend so much on pay raises? It's the one thing I don't like about TEW 16 as opposed to 13. I want to spend my $300 on all of you like I had been doing. I don't want to spend $1,000. I signed you for 300, let me use you for 300. Just be happy. That's why Matt sold Omega Kush is legal in the Netherlands. He's just doing wrestling shows in the brothels. Ah, one second. I'm scratching my back. I have a back scratcher I like to use. My one of my buddies has like a head scratcher that's amazing. I need to find it. I need to find one of my own. Oh, sorry. Oh, DPW set their sights. They've made several contract offers in the past 2 days. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Mark Sherman wants more money. Alright. Well, he's not asking too much, I guess. Fuck. I wonder who Matt Hardy's looking to bring in. And if there's anyone I know that they have. I think I've heard of Blue Nikita before. I feel like I have. Christian! Dude, he brought in Christian. Okay. Well, that's a good start. Matt Hardy and Christian. Oh, dude. Christian moved to France. That is awesome. Christian moved to France, and now he and Matt Hardy can run their own Dutch promotion. Why? I don't know why that's a thing, but okay, that's a thing. Matt Hardy is... it's in the contract. I don't have to pay for your travel, Matt, so... Don't ask. How good is Christian at being a road agent? 71.98. That's actually not bad. It's Christian. I don't know. How do you say it is in Dutch? Or Dutch isn't a Dutch isn't a language, I don't think. No, I think it is. I can't remember now. I feel like an idiot for not knowing. A lot of people I've never heard of. Is the only... Jessica Love is the only transgender wrestler in Europe. World of wrestling already full of colorful personalities. Fights one-on-one with the men and women using her charm to her advantage. What's her skill set like? I think I need to go over to Dragon Gate. We'll have Jessica Love face off against Yosuke Santa Maria. Every fucking night. That is going to be a 3-year-long storyline where it's just two transgender wrestlers, a European one, a Finnish one, and a Japanese one fighting each other. I'll even bring in Hardcore Homo Angel to be there every once in a while. I do know Alpha Female. She doesn't quite look like that anymore. She's got longer blonde hair. Because she works for Stardom. This looks like a guy I could get behind. Jessica Love is draw. Do work in agreement with a Dutch fan. She seems very average. I'll have her work the women's division. Feud with Jessica Havoc. Just get her all pissed off. Like, that's a man! Well, look at the size of you. Does that mean you're a man? Fuck off! You know, just bullshit like that. Alright. Let's set this before we look at the locker room incidents and see what has happened. Now, I'll keep my hopes up because they've usually been pretty good. So, we'll see what happens. Oh, already added that one. I wish there was like a confirmation type click where I would know that it's been hit. Goldust should just think of Jessica's a woman when he's really a man, then Goldust goes... Alright, locker room incidents, what happened? What happened with Eric Bischoff? He entertained the locker room by organizing a poker tournament. Actually, that kind of sounds like Eric Bischoff. That does kind of sound like Eric Bischoff, honestly. That's alright. I'll wait until November 2017. Well, that's alright. I'm going to probably do those out, all through... how injured is... Okay, Akira Tozawa's out for the next, like, 2.5 months. Kairi Hojo is out for the next 9, and Ethan Carter III is just plain not here. Cool. really making it worth my money. There we go. Oh, come on down. Valair. I'm going to keep working here until we actually fill the place up. So, doing pretty well right now. Everything's doing pretty hot. Here we go. Bel Air working there. How many did we draw last time? 2850. So maybe we'll draw about 2900 this time. How much did we draw for the anniversary show? We drew 2885 and then 2850. So I think we'll probably do a little bit better because we've been improving each time so far. So 62, 64, 66. Maybe we can do even better now. We will start off hot with a wrestling match. By the way, after that meniscus tear of Io Shirai, I assumed she was going to be able to work through it a lot longer, a lot quicker than a year. But you know what? I don't really mind all that much, simply because I've got plans. So I guess she doesn't need to be a focal point in wrestling. You start looking like WCW, well known in home state, unknown outside. I think that's basically how this turns out. I think when I look at size, that pretty much tells me what it's like. Pretty well known in the Midwest. Everywhere else, no one cares. All right, we'll start off with a match. Let's see. I'm trying to see what I want to do first. Let's do this, and we'll have... We should probably save Matt Hardy for a main event, shouldn't we? Let's not have him come out immediately. But who we will have come out immediately, we'll work on let's see, Io Shirai. She is the champion. She hasn't wrestled in a little bit. We'll have her wrestle Sara Lee, Kimberly, Katarina Lee. You know what? We'll have her face Katarina Lee. Io Shirai is carrying an injury. This may have impacted... Dude, she's the champion, and she's going to be holding that for the next year, so I'm going to have to kind of get over that, I think. That's why we're opening up with this. We'll do Io Shirai. Be a regular match. We will keep... Katarina Lee strong. Open match. You have bigger women's division than WWE. They have four women now. let's do. Man, we should probably make it maybe a decisive finish, but. This is going to be interference to Katarina Lee. Oh, man, who is she feuding? Oh, Mary Dobson. That's right. So Mary Dobson gets involved with that. So she has kind of an excuse as to why she lost. Yes. So we'll leave it at that. Let's move backstage. Let's see, what should we... I'm going to look at the history combined with what I am working on doing at some point. Alright, I've got an idea. We will do... If I play Pokemon Go, my phone can play it, but, like, the GPS is really wonky on it, So I kind of gave up on playing it because the GPS didn't want to work. And I've had friends tell me, it's like, oh, you just have to wait a little bit. And it's like, yeah, but I've waited like 5 minutes before and it still didn't recognize it. So I kind of gave up on it for right now just because it's like, it means I'd have to go and leave and walk around and do stuff like that. And like, I do that on the weekends, but oh God, what was I going to do? Alright, okay. Let's see. Dario Cueto. The Big O. Big O is in Dario's office. And wants to know if he can get a shot at Omega's trophy. Dario refuses. Just a couple minutes, 2-3 minutes there. Give them both a shot on the microphone. Doing a little deal backstage where Big O really wants a shot at getting Kenny Omega's deal. We'll have this tie-in. Let's see here. Let's do... Let's do a freestyle angle. Jim Neidhart died in your save? Shit. The Big O. And then we'll send out Kenny Omega. So Big O and Kenny Omega. Kenny Omega, or Big O's in the ring for a match. Omega cuts him down. And, oops. Introduces Loa as his opponent. So, yeah, I think that's how we'll just do a couple minutes with that. Where it's just a quick kind of rundown. He's kind of getting run down here. Minor success with that. Tangaloa gets introduced. So we have Tangaloa versus the Big O. Do that. We got about 8 minutes. Oh man, how do I want to work this? Let's give the win to Big O. There's definitely storytelling here. Tangaloa is going to be kept strong. It's an open match. And I say distraction on Tangaloa by Tama Tonga. There we go. Do that whole ordeal. So we'll do Kenny Omega, Cody Hall, Tangaloa, Tama Tonga, the Big O, and then Dustin. Oh, we haven't actually put him on the dealio yet. You know what? We'll leave it at this for right now. We'll have to go back because I need to actually assign Dustin Rhodes a position, and I think I want to do something with him. I forgot about that. Main event. Oh God. Okay. Let's just do an auto push for this. Just to put everyone where they should be. All right. Where's our roster look like now? Killings, Dustin Rhodes, EC3, Reynolds, Kushida, Tangalo and Tama Tonga, Upper Mid, Rosh Singh, Upper Mid, Big O, Matt Hardy. Okay. Damn. Shame for some of those guys who had to move down a little bit, but, eh. Okay. So let's see here. Tangalo versus the Big O. So I think after the match with the Big O getting involved, or getting like that sneaky win, so Kenny Omega, Tangaloa, Cody Hall, what did I say? The Big O and Tama Tonga. Whoops. So we'll just do selling for everybody. Because that's what it basically is. Minor success, minor success, minor success, minor defeat, minor defeat. And low on this. Bullet Club performs a post-match beatdown on Tama and Big O and leave them laying. So we'll just leave it at that, and we'll give them about 4 minutes to do their thing. Alright. I think what I want to do, I'm gonna actually deal with this right here. I'm gonna do Eric Bischoff out of all people. Actually, let me see. Is Eric Bischoff technically a heel? I don't remember if I technically have him as a heel. Can I actually see here if he is? I need to see. I have him technically as a face. And Chael Sonnen here too. Bischoff should be able to talk better than Sonnen. So we'll give him an opportunity to do that. So we throw it back to Eric Bischoff. And Chael Sonnen at the desk. And we'll do entertainment on both. Maybe a minor success for Bischoff. Bischoff takes off his headset. And Chael Sonnen, he needs to talk to Dario about Bullet Club. Eric Bischoff, maybe you sign Vince Russo. I don't really want to sign Russo and Ed Ferrara. I think I'm good enough as is. So we'll just give that a minute on there. Chael Sonnen, work without a script. We'll let them both work without a script. How about that? So he takes off his headset, Chael Sonnen, and he's going to go talk to Dario. So we'll set up for another deal here. Let's see. Let's do a quick match. Let's see. Let's do a women's match. We did one women's match. We'll do another women's match. Who haven't I used? I haven't used Evie for much of anything quite yet. We'll have Evie come out, because I don't remember the last time I quite used her in a match. Cornette, have a rivalry between Russo and Cornette, Jesus. Okay. Evie versus Jessica Havoc. I'm sorry, Evie, I'm going to have to feed you to Havoc. So Jessica Havoc, do an ad. Can they both technically work a different style? She's aerial and flashiness, if anything, and she's brawling and hard. Now we'll just keep it at a regular wrestling match then. Be storytelling, and the big story is the Eevees at least giving it a good go, just couldn't quite get it done. Havoc just straight up outpowered her. So, Jessica Havoc, Sue Young. Havoc celebrates. Post-match. Havoc celebrates post-match. Young comes up from the ring. And attacks her. Yeah, we'll just leave it at that. So, selling and selling. That's not really minor success now, is it? Injury risk low. There we go. Havoc celebrates post-match. Sue Young comes up from the ring and attacks her. So that's when, let's see, we'll go here. I want to do a slight bit here, because I haven't used him yet. So we're going to do Cody Hall, Colby Carino. Carino sees Hall in the hall. God damn it. Carino sees Hall backstage. And wants to know what he's doing with Bullet Club. Hall brushes him off and leaves. Ah. Just Hall brushes him off, I guess. Put a few pros in that promo, Jesus. Let's see. So, neither one of these guys are all that entertaining. They're not, they might not do all that well. You know what? We're gonna use Cody Hall for, Menace. He kind of, like, stares him down to intimidate him. And the big deal with that is I'm gonna look at Colby Carino. And while he's not as good, we haven't had Colby Carino as a, he's been a heel since day one for the last 2 years, and I think it might be high time to take a shot at turning him face, but we're gonna need a build up, so we're gonna start the build up now. For that deal. Let's see. Then we'll go back to another angle here. Eric Bischoff. There we go. Carino should be your ace. Carino is definitely going to be, like, a future top star for my promotion. Being only 21, he's going to be big for me. There we go. Bischoff demands to know what Dario is doing. Not punishing Bullet Club. Dario has him escorted out. Escorted back to announcing. Oh. Back to his table. Here, we'll do that. Let's see. If you play this like 6 years in game time. Oh yeah, we're already 2 years in, so. Let's just do away. He's basically escorted back to his table. to his announce desk after all of this. He's basically dressed down and like, just leave. Just go away. Take the scripts off them, that should work out well. let's see, who haven't I used yet this month? I haven't used Dash, well that's fine, Dash isn't going to be used. Redman, Robinson, two guys I don't have for much of anything, so you know what we'll do? We're going to put them together. We're gonna make this work with the boat. We'll see how well these two work together. I think I've had them wrestle before. When there was that match back in June, and I think maybe in TEW 13 they had some matches. But let's see how well they work together. We'll give them 10 minutes and see what they can show off. Let's do Joel Redman to win this one. We're gonna keep Juice strong though. Open match, decisive win, just a basic win, and I don't know how good of a promo Redman is, not much. Redman, Redman grabs a mic. Let everyone know his intention of becoming champ soon. Won't really happen too much, but just a couple minutes. I think we'll be building off of this. We'll use Joel Redman as a catalyst for one of these things. I think that that would work out well. Susan and Carter Pete Dunsmake. Okay. I just wanted to see where they were at. Sorry, I had to stretch a little bit there. Shit. Ooh. Oh, my neck's like stiff. That's not good. Ooh. Cool. Let's see, what other angle should I do here? Young's win, let's see. Hang on one second, I'm just kind of getting a beat onto, what I want to work on here. Alright. I don't have much of anything for him just because EC3 is not here, but Matt Hardy is backstage to talk about his match later on tonight. We'll get something going here. Yeah. We'll even take the script off him, because I think he'll be just fine. Here we go. We'll lead us to another match here, which I want to do Cody Hall. And, oh god, actually, we probably shouldn't put it this late into the show. I was going to do Cody Hall and Patrick Clark, but I just realized we're over an hour in. Let's not. Matt Hardy should plug his Dutch Fed. That's exactly what we do. That's his match later on tonight, and then he plugs his Dutch Pro Wrestling. Because why not? You know what I should do? Because he wrestled last time, and he'll wrestle again this time. And that's Pete Dunne taking on... He beat Lance and Noai, so let's give him... Matt Cage should probably be the guy that he beats this time. We can even make it competitive. A competitive 10 minutes between Cage and Dunn. I bet you these guys could probably go longer, couldn't they? He's an 83 stamina. He's an 80 stamina. Ooh. Ooh, hang on. I saw aerial and flashiness, and not so much chain wrestling. He can kind of do chain wrestling. Pete Dunne kind of do chain wrestling. I don't know if I want to try to do technical masterclass for these two, but I bet you we can make this like a dark horse type match here. Let's see. 15 minutes of ring time. Crowd engaged, but not overly rowdy. Alright, we'll give him a shot at technical masterclass for this match. Fuck it. Pete Dunne to be the victor. Matt Cage should be kept strong. Open match, which I think they're both mid-carders anyway, so... But a decisive win nonetheless. Actually, what I'll probably have it do is... I don't think he has a submission, but I'll give him a submission finish. Taps him out. Before the match... There we go. Matt Cage pre-match grabs a mic and brags about his big win at Anniversary 2, which I believe happened, right? You won. Yeah, you won. Man, he's on a roll. Buddy is on a roll. All right. We'll see what happens here. Let's see if him having a highly competitive 18-minute technical masterclass match with Pete Dunne helps him out at all. It should help out Pete. Pete Dunne's been doing quite well for himself, so I think he'll do just fine. Give him 18 minutes for that. Pete Dunne gets a win. Yeah, save that. That should be good. Let's see here. What should I cut to after that? Goddamn. We're at... I'm just trying to see where we're at kind of in the hierarchy of things to come. We have not used Kushida yet. We have not used... Raj Singh, who are both faces. We've not used Marty Skrull's, not going to be around right now. Yuma, and some women's division people. Oma Watanabe, Sarah Lee. We should probably make that like a pre-match deal. I'm going to add that for a pre-match. There we go. Momo. Sarah Lee. Pre-show. Momo will be the victor. We'll protect Sarah Lee. Open match. Flash pinfall. There we go. I don't know if Sarah Lee's won a match yet for me. She got one win. What happened? Oh yeah, she won back at Anniversary. That's right. So Momo will get a roll-up victory against Sarah Lee in the pre-match. There you go. So we've used them. I want to make sure I use everyone. Let me see. Dash isn't going to be used. So you have Kushida. Raj Singh. Skrull not going to be used right now. Yuma. I mean, I guess I do face versus face isn't going to do me all that well, but might just be a match to throw in, maybe. Or I could at least use them in an angle. Why not? I'll use Raj Singh and Yuma. They've got their history. 2MD is backstage. They discuss how... their partnership... just hasn't worked out. Because I might be getting rid of Yuma soon. So we'll just make that a thing. Entertainment for both. Can't remember how much I'm paying Yuma. It isn't much, I know that much, but I mean, I'm not using him for anything. He's $200 if I don't need him around. I don't think he's helping me out all that much right now. There we go. Oh, Jesus, where am I at? Matt Hardy's gonna have to have a match against somebody. Maybe Omega. Did we put Omega in a match? We put Omega in a match 2 weeks ago. But, let me see. We got Dash isn't gonna be used. Marty's not gonna be used. Kushida. We'll put a small angle here. Promo video showcasing Degeneration Dash's fall at Anniversary 2. So they're technically not involved. So they're technically off screen because it's a promo video, so. There we go. Dash, entertainment, sex appeal. Why not? There we go. Let's see here. What else do we have? I probably should have done Marty Scurll for, like, selling. He's probably a better seller than anything. Not to mention it's his fall, so it doesn't seem to make sense to use that bit there. Let's see here. So Matt Hardy's going to be in the main event. Who he's going to face, I'm not 100% sure yet. Tangaloa, we've used Tangaloa. Are we going to use Kenny Omega in the main event? That seems like a noteworthy enough main event, don't you think? Kenny Omega versus Matt Hardy. I feel like Hall... I want to put Cody Hall in a match. But we're going to have a local guy, I think, who can maybe work with him. Oh, man. Alex Payne. Let me see. Someone who can work with him. Let's see. Is there someone new that we haven't really quite seen yet on here? Chris Chetty, for some reason, is in here. They always, some guys, sometimes they just tend to move, like other, like people who might be in Midwest at one show won't be in Midwest, like, later on. It's weird. Cage, I think I've seen Cage before. Chris Kloss, the XPW guy, who his main thing that he's known for is just screaming. Steel Luger. Oh man, this is our like monthly who are we gonna bring in for a match. Mikey Betts is retired. Steiner. We can bring in Steiner again. Sam Fatu. God damn. We just bring Tadarius Thomas back from nowhere. Tony DeVito, Tracy Taylor, Tomko, Murdoch. We haven't used Murdoch for much of anything. What's Murdoch's stats look like? Murdoch might be able to do fine. We'll negotiate a one-night deal for Trevor Murdoch. AHTU. I've never heard of him either. 43 years old, so probably not the best idea in the world. He's not all that great. I should try to get Alex Kozlov. But we'll do... No, oh, I need to assign him a position. Shit, who did I just sign? Fuck, I'm dumb. Trevor Murdoch. He's a lower mid-carder. He'll just be occasional wrestler for right now. He works a better heel, but we'll make him face. Because we need a face. What can he play? Crazy. Brute. Let's do... I don't know if there's a face brute. A good face brute. We'll see. Anarchist, badass, bully, cosmic warrior, comrade, demon hunter, extremist, the muscle, underground fighter, warrior. He's gonna be a demon hunter. I don't know why. I'm gonna make him like, oh god, what was that? What was that, like, B movie? Tucker and Dale versus Evil. That's what Trevor Murdoch is, the wrestling incarnation of Tucker and Dale versus Evil. That's what he's gonna be. He's gonna be a redneck demon hunter. Russian brute Murdoch. Trevor Murdoch. Murdoch Crush! Cody Hall. Leon Trevor Murdoch. By the way, where is Hall on the... he's also a lower mid-carder. Alright. We'll give him 10 minutes. I think, actually, Trevor Murdoch is technically the better wrestler. The much more solid wrestler out of the both of them. So that's actually kind of funny. Maybe Lance Cade's spirit in urn comes out with Murdoch. That's like his good luck charm. You know, the funny thing about this is I think, honest to God... I think, honest to God, Trevor Murdoch might actually be carrying Cody Hall for this match. I guess we'll find out. We're gonna make it a tainted win, since it's kind of a decently well-known guy, and it's only Cody Hall. So... so we'll do Kenny Omega. Omega is backstage discussing how tonight he rids himself of Matt Hardy. Just a couple minutes there. Entertainment, minor success, there we go. And I think that leads us to our main event of the evening. Which leads us Kenny Omega taking on Matt Hardy. They haven't... Okay, it was that ladder match. So, it does make some sense. We're giving him like 18 minutes, I think. He's got 80 stamina. Matt Hardy should be just fine, too. Yeah, I think these guys could pull it off. Ooh, I just realized. Omega psychology is shit. Otherwise, not shit, but not nearly as good as Matt's, which means they can't just call it in the ring. we'll give, who would I want to give this to? I know how I want the post-match to go. I don't know who I want to win this. Just woke up when you fell asleep. You're out of what I did in the last few minutes. It's fine. I think Cody Hall is going to have a match against Trevor Murdoch. And Cody Hall is going to beat Trevor Murdoch in a close match, and now I'm booking the main event. Using the psychology to add drama. Let's actually slow build this. I think we can get a nice slow build match for this. God, I don't know who's going to win, though. Let's give Omega the win. We'll give Omega a cheap win, but he's got it. Matt Hardy's still going to be kept strong, though. Open match. Tainted win. Maybe a distraction by on Matt Hardy by Tangaloa. There we go. All right. So we want Kenny Omega, Cody Hall, Tangaloa, Matt Hardy, and Tama Tonga, and Dustin Rhodes. So, BC beat down Hardy. Tama comes out for save. Gets beaten. Dustin Rhodes debuts. Let's see. He's not gonna like physically clean house. I got some room to talk about it. Just a few words. Chase him off. How about that? Dustin Rhodes debuts to chase them off. Like, legit, like, what? Just a couple days after he got let go from his... Like, it's just a few days after he officially got released from WWE. No 90-day clause or any... Well, actually, no. His contract ran out, so there wouldn't have been a 90-day clause. As far as I know. I mean, it's not like it would have been legally binding anyway, but I digress. Raw running 3 a.m. to 6 a.m. in your country. Wednesday morning, you have to watch SmackDown from 3 a.m. to 5 a.m. Damn. Yeah, anytime overseas is just cuckoo with those times. So, selling, Menace, selling. Fuck it. Since it's supposed to be a big debut, we'll actually try overness with this. Success. We'll do low, minor successes for them, I guess, because they're beating down Hardy and Tonga. And then, of course, Dustin Rhodes coming out. So that should be it, right there. 127 minutes. At the end of the show is when we get the... Dustin Rhodes debut. I was going to do it early in the show, but I decided to leave it for the tail end, and then next week is when we can really start getting into why he's here, the storyline reason as to why he's here, because I've already kind of built him into the storyline, so we'll work this in. You guys didn't see it, but I was actually making like hand gestures as I was saying that, like as if you could see me. So I guess it's time to run the show. I think we did just about everything we could possibly do here. Kushida didn't get a chance to do anything. Let's give him something. Let's give him an angle. Kushida, what can he do? What can he do that doesn't require... Give him a sex appeal segment? Feels like fun. Okay, I don't remember him speaking fluent English. What happened? I don't remember him speaking fluent English. Did he, like, learn more of the language over time? I'm almost positive that that wasn't a thing. Let's see. Kushida comes out. Claims he will be back in the ring soon. Yeah, the whole thing with him and Tozawa is kind of out the window now that Tozawa's pretty much out for the next, like, what, nine months at least? What was it? Six? I can't remember how long he's out. A while. Oh, yeah, like, two and a half at least. Was he in USA, so we learned it. Is that really a thing? Because I know he had, like, basic, because the last time I looked, he could speak basic English, and then it became, like, maybe passable English, but it seems weird that he's already got fluent language. I mean, I guess working for Global Force probably helped as well. But that's kind of cool, if that does have a impact on it. Alright, so now I've used everybody this month. Right? Okay. Cool. Killings technically isn't on this show, I just kind of realized that. Well, okay, he's going to be involved in the Io Shirai thing, because I believe he's Io Shirai's manager. Right? Right, yep. So he is technically there. Even though he says he's not booked, he's booked. Alright, I guess we'll do this. Of course, that was a shit show of a segment. Sara Lee actually outperformed Momo Watanabe. Congratulations. Seemed to lack a flow to the match, which took away from the drama. Terrible pre-show match. A great, great promo, which led into, got the show off to a strong start. 2790. Shit, we're regressing. Why are we continually regressing in the amount of people coming to the show? We've had a string of great shows, and why are there less people showing up? Shirai was slowed by injury. Her and Katarina Lee didn't really come out with a great match, but they still... Io Shirai still ended up pulling out a 60, and we still got a 54 out of that match. It's probably going to be better than the... maybe better than the Evie-Jessica Havoc one, who knows? Dario Cueto and Big O, of course, Big O kind of, we'll have something as far as a further conclusion to the Dario Cueto Big O thing, and Big O wanting an opportunity at Kenny Omega's trophy. And then, of course, Big O's in the ring for a match. Omega cuts him down, introduces Tangaloa, then they have a halfway decent match. yeah. Big O handled himself in that match. That's pretty cool. Tama Tonga distracted. Big O got a submission. a beat down by the Bullet Club, of course, to leave them laying. Bischoff is just sick to death of it. People have work on Mondays and new shows on Sundays, I guess. But it's still... it's not like it's going to be a late-night show. It only airs late-night. Evie versus Jessica Havoc, yeah. Look at that. Io Shirai's injured. She pulled a better match out of Katarina Lee than Evie and Jessica Havoc did at full strength. Congratulations. Then, of course, Jessica Havoc, Su Yung. Su Yung coming up from the ring, pulling her in. Yeah, Carino trying to kind of talk Hall out of what he's doing. Hall brushes him off. We're going to continue without addressing the turn. Bischoff talks to Dario Cueto. They seem to do pretty well clicking together. Redman versus Robinson. Pulled off a 55. That's not bad. I think we can maybe work with that. Oh. Joel Redman sustained anterior interstitial syndrome. What the fuck? I'm gonna have to see what the fuck that is. That's not good. Why are my guys constantly getting injured? Can we not get injured, guys? Yeah, I gotcha. I'm gonna be champ soon, as he's grabbing whatever the fuck he just injured. I don't even know. Matt Hardy. This isn't doing the hottest. This is a kind of a lame show compared to the rest of it. We aren't nearly as hot as we've been. Pete Dunne, Matt Cage. Does all right, honestly. Pete Dunne doing quite well with a 68. I really like that. Match was poorly placed. Technical match wasn't the right thing to be feeding a rowdy crowd. Well, they were going to be rowdy, I think, regardless. But, okay. Yeah, they talk about the breakup of Rush Singh and Yuma. Yuma's probably gone. We'll see. Dash and Marty Scurll. Let's see. Cody Hall, Trevor Murdoch. Of course, that doesn't do all that well. Trevor Murdoch plainly carried that. I knew Murdoch was going to do pretty well. Maybe I should be looking into Murdoch instead of Yuma. I bet you Murdoch could probably do better as a lower mid-carder. He'd cost a little bit more, but fuck it. You should watch that Dragon Gate show in Discord and new ride along with the club. All right. Thanks, Jack. Yeah, I'm just about done, so I'll have to check that out. But thanks for coming by. Let's see. Omega's backstage. How he's going to rid himself of Matt Hardy. Kenny Omega and Matt Hardy did quite well. Great wrestling and decent reaction from the crowd. Eventually, Kenny Omega, using underhanded tactics, won. While Tangaloa distracted Matt Hardy. Everything clicked really well with that. Then the whole final segment, 64, nice, with Dustin Rhodes. He got an above average rating, so that's good, I guess, for his weird gimmick. His mysterious gimmick. As kind of the quote-unquote kind of enforcer of the whole thing. 65, actually not bad at all. I'm gonna give it up to Pete Dunne again for his great performance. Probably not gonna mean much, but I'm gonna compliment Trevor Murdoch on carrying Cody Hall. And I'm also gonna give it up to Io Shirai for doing as well as she did with her injury. Cool. Because I guess Sue Young and Jessica Havoc are just going to be pissed off at me forever. Nothing that I do is helping, so I can heap praise on them all the time. It's not going to help. They're just going to be pissed at me for a while, I guess. Look at that. So it's that one minus, the Furious at the booking of a match back in May. Since then, I've given her bonuses, post-show speeches, everything. She's just still annoyed with me. I don't get it. And then Sue Young's kind of the same way. The booking of a match back in May, another thing. Turns, all sorts of stuff. Jesus. Any click buildings? I mean, there's some odd stuff. Like, Jake Roberts is taking Cody Hall, and Cody Hall, Colby Carino, and Patrick Clark under his wing as a protege. So Cody Hall, Colby Carino, and Patrick Clark are all protégés of Jake Roberts, which is amazing to me. We'll have to see the severity of that. What's the severity of... he's working through it. Okay. So he's just a little hurt. Just working hurt. Tangaloa's feeling the effects of a grueling recent schedule. That's fine. I'll probably forget, but... 0.02 TV rating. Quite okay. After that... Let's see, pay rise request from Pete Dunne. I kind of figured that was, wow, that's almost $1,000. But I am kind of building him up. I need to stop smacking my microphone. I'm so sorry, that's going to sound awful, I bet. There we go. Popularity-wise, oh god. Oh god, he's certainly becoming pretty well right now. He's certainly getting along nicely. What happened? He was not that good. He was not that popular. Look, it's just me and Noah. Did I do this? Did I serious? Oh my god. Look at that. This is where I started this 2016 game. This is where he's at now after one, two, three, four, five, 6 months. 6 months of work on Pete Dunne, making him look like a credible threat for a future championship. And this is where he went from 0 to 40 in 6 months in my promotion. Jesus Christ. That is ridiculous. That is just some ridiculousness right there. And I know it's me, because I'm the only American company that he works for. It can't be anybody else. Because Noah, I don't think, has any American television. So it's only me that's making him this way. Oh my god. Let's see. Oh, okay, so they do have a little bit. They have Fox Sports Midwest, KDOC TV, Lone Star Television Network, New England Sports Network, and WBNA 21. So, okay. I guess it's a little bit of both. And the fact that he's working more Noah matches than here. But he's getting up there fast. It's pretty insane. Io Shirai's getting up there too. As far as I remember, yeah, she's getting pretty up there. She was a 12 when we started. She's now at a 40 now that we have television to work with. So I'm feeling pretty good about all that. Doing pretty well. It's a new month. We made $37,000 in profit, which means we're going to have to stop taking all the credit from Dunn. I'm not saying it's like it's all me, but like I was just sitting here thinking, it was like he's been putting on great shows, but then it's also like I assumed that most of that popularity was coming from working for my company as opposed to somewhere else, because I didn't assume Noah was going to have anything in America. I'm up to 37th in ranking, so that's pretty nice. Have I hopscotched over anyone yet? No, House of Hardcore. I think I'm technically above House of Hardcore now. I don't know, where is House of Hardcore at? They're 39th. But still, they would rather, EC3 would rather work for them before me. I don't get it. I want to use them, but... So, how much are you asking for? 1,400. I'm gonna go ahead and shortlist you and consider you. Yeah, Bobby Fish, I think, would be a good candidate to add. If Ring of Honor doesn't want him, I think I could probably find a good spot for Bobby Fish. So, alright. That did pretty well there. Let's see. Popularity-wise, we went up to a 34. Went up a little bit just about anywhere else. I think the places where I don't have TV... and I just have internet, they're going to go up very slowly. So I may have to look into... Honestly, at a $37,000 profit, I either need to A, look into more expensive people that can help me put on even better shows. B, I forget the line of thought that I thought about. Oh, a third show a month to try to maybe do more shows a month might be another option as well. That might be an option. Either A, more expensive people, B, an extra show a month, or C, start upping the production values. That may help me. It's not hindering me right now, but it may help me. I guess we'll see. So, that's something to look forward to. Prestige 26. Momentum, I think, has definitely gone up. Since we're at a 60 now. I think we're at like a 56 or something. Up to 37th, so we've already jumped up three more spots. So we are definitely on our way. It's definitely a long cry away from the 10 people we had on our first show. Dead last, no one else. This is definitely a far cry away from that. And I am kind of excited about when we get through January to hopefully try to get some better TV stations. Weekly TV show, two events per month. I think I may end up waiting until our TV deals are done and then look into an actual weekly TV show. I think that's what I'll be looking forward to at the end of the year. And when our contracts are up with our broadcasters. As of right now, we have 3 months left on all of these. So that takes us through November, December, and January. At the end of January, we'll probably look at trying to get a weekly 1 hour TV show. And a weekly 1 hour TV show. And hopefully a better spot than late night. Because we got late night everywhere right now, and we're doing a hell of a lot better than E+. So I'm thinking we could probably do a hell of a lot better. I don't know if we can already negotiate for a better spot. Oh, yeah, we technically could negotiate for a better time slot, but let's just get through this contract first. And then once we get through January, then we can look into new people. New potential bigger broadcasters. 1 hour weekly TV show, and then start using Infamous as like almost like in-your-house type pay-per-views. Where they're like the pay-per-views in between the big four that we already have set up. That could probably be a big deal. Two events a month? We could do two events a month. I might just slim it down to maybe one if we're doing the TV show. Because then that'll give us 1, 2, 3, 4, like 6 hours. That'll give us an additional like 2 hours of wrestling to book a month if we do a 1 hour TV show four times a week. Or one time a week. And then an event at the end. So a basic TV, like a basic WWE, TNA, whatever style of weekly TV shows, and then a pay-per-view at the end, you know. But not quite pay-per-view just yet, just an event. So yeah, definitely look forward to that. Definitely doing a hell of a lot better, and we are on our way to the end of the road. In December, where's the schedule? Yeah, I have a slightly different colored, I think, logo that I may have to change that to. But yeah, I'll have to figure that out within a few streams. I still got at least a couple more months to book and worry about all that. So I'll figure that out later. So let's just get through at least the end of the year, and then the whole cross promotion deal I want to do, and then we can figure that all out after that. So thank you guys for coming out. I do greatly appreciate it. For you guys who watch this on YouTube, I greatly appreciate you guys continuing to watch this on YouTube. And, I cannot wait for bigger and better things. So I will see you guys next time.